Assalamu alaikum everyone. Good morning and good afternoon. I don't know what time you are actually watching this video. So let's start for the second module. It is about the individual level behavior. So individually you have to study individual person on psychological basis or social basis. Normally most of the theories are coming from the psychological psychology and psychological discipline. So let's try to define in this module 2, the very first week we are going to talk about your personality. And you think that you are working in some organization like Bank Muscat or Bank Suhar or anywhere in Omani firm, then you have to think how you are going to be judged or how you can judge the people. So very fundamental thing about this is the personality. So if we talk about this objectives and we are going to understand how the individual's behavior can impact the effectiveness of the organization. If you are in a good mood, if you are in a bad mood, if you have a good personality, if you have an introvert personality, if you have an extrovert personality, these all things are actually related to workplace, and at workplace organizational effectiveness matters more. So let's talk about this thing further, that is your personality. And if I ask you a simple question, who are you? You may tell us that I'm a Omani citizen. I may ask you, okay, further, can you tell me, do you like to do what sort of job? For example, you like to do some programming job, or you want to be doing some marketing job or anything like that, you can tell us further. Similarly, if I go further, I may ask you, do you like to enjoy the parties, or do you like to stay at home and doing and enjoying your work at a laptop or your mobile? Then you may express me more. So these things do matter at the workplace. So while you are relating these things with the workplace, we call them to personality to organization fit. Your personality should fit with your organization. So if we go a little further in defining these terms, we can read some technical definitions. Personality is a dynamic concept describing the growth and development of the person's whole psychological system. Your whole psychology is built on your environment, your internal feeling, your confidence, and all those things. And in the future, if you work as an HR manager, you should judge and you should measure the personality of the people in a way that you fit them according to particular job. So they should enjoy more, rather they should shy more. So this is the very important thing we are going to discuss today. And what are the determinants? Let's talk about the, for example, is the personality the result of the environment or your biological things? The old theorists are discussing it. For example, inherently, if you are cold-blooded or hot-blooded, you will be extrovert by default. Or you can groom your personality with the help of environment. For example, you can do some trainings and build your confidence in this regard. You can still groom your personality or leadership traits in this regard. So these are the things that different theorists have suggested. And the most thing is the structure of the genes, and all those things are also do matters. But we will not go in the biological combination of the personality, rather we will stay focused on the psychological combination of the personality and how to relate it with the workplace. So let's talk about this big five, and normally it's a very good theory, and you can see it's a very summative type of theory where you can talk about openness and extroversion, agreeableness and neuroticism. So let's try to understand what are these three basic traits are, and I will give you in your exercise how to measure your personality in an Excel sheet where you will click and you will try to get some numbers and you will try to interpret as an activity, as a formative exercise as well, and you will try to judge which sort of job is very good for you and which job should not continue. So let's try and focus on this. Openness is about the creative, open to the ideas, curious and original. So if you think about any person like programmer, or you think about any video director or recorder, they are very creative people sometimes. But they are on the scale of, this is sometimes very subjective, but we will try to quantify it and remain very objective in this regard. If I ask you to scale yourself for the openness 1 to let's say 10, you will give some number and some marks to it. So you can be a very open or you can be less open in this regard. And this can help you for your particular job in this regard. If your job demands more creativity and openness of the ideas, then you should be more open in this regard. Then conscientiousness, being organized, systematic, punctual and dependable. So this is another feature which is on demand for your job. So if you're doing your job or you are as an HR manager acting, then you will check for this personality trait as well. So further, extroversion is really important. And if you see, sometime you are doing marketing job, then you should be outgoing, talkative, social, and enjoying the social situation in this regard. But if you are getting less score, then you should go for the finance job and anything like that, and you will apply the same at workplace. So agreeableness, being affordable, tolerant, sensitive, trusting, kind, and warm with others. So it is also a good property, which this property says, and you have to check at which scale you are actually performing more. So neuroticism is normally another thing which is normally taken as a negative, but we will talk about its positive side as well. For example, being anxious and moody sometimes. Normally this thing will go in the negative side. If you are very much moody and you are not a morning person, not coming in a discipline, then you should join some profession, for example, programming. You can raise up late, and once you feel in happy mood, then you can be very creative at the same and introvert at the same time. So these are not your negative side. God has developed you like this. So if you try to identify these traits in a way that will help you to do a better job, then this theory is really good for you at workplace. So let's talk a little more detail about this theory, and one by one we will try to compare how this introvert and extrovertness is going. If you are introvert, means enjoy spending time alone, while otherwise you are at the gathering at the same time. The other thing is, if you try to differentiate that things before speaking and acting are make quick decisions, means you are very thinking, and I should take this decision, or even you will feel it during your shopping habits, that you will be very choosy, you will be taking a lot of options, which one is the more good quality of the product and which is less expensive. But some people, you will see, they go and take just shoes and come back in just 5 minutes from the shopping mall. So this is reflecting your introvertness or extrovertness at the same time. So being seen as more reserved or more enthusiastic, so this is the warm feeling of yourself, and you have to take care of this as well. So let's go further and let's compare the sensing and intuition. So it is another important feeling. If you see, it is here with the downward. Sometimes you see some people are downward more, but some are more future oriented and visionary at the same time. So some are more practical at the same time, then they are more sensing. And intuition, they are worried about future, and they can be a good planner, and they can go for strategic planning, not for themselves but also for the organization. So while organization is hiring, they should take care of what sort of traits are built in with such peoples and how they fit with their organization. So if you continue with more detail, it is sensing are more detail oriented, and while the other intuitive type of personalities are more focused on meanings and read between the lines, and these are the things which are a different level of use at for the different jobs. So if you continue with this, we have some Indian theory as well. This is based on the biological and appearance as well. So based on this, we have actually three: Vata, Pitta, and Kapha. Three things are there. And let's say if you are like water, then you go for the Vata. And if based on this, you will actually predict you are like bending air, and you are going to be very comfortable. You means according to environment, you will adjust, and you have some problem, maybe biological problem they have predicted. For example, joint pain could be there, and depression, you can be depressed very easily. These are the physical symptoms and psychological things which they have tried to predict based on the Indian psychology. So Pitta is about the water, and it talks more about, for example, you may have some urine injury with you. You may have some rashes, and you may have very red skin. But at the same time, you are very good leader at the same time, because you are very energetic and you like to join some executive post. So you see, I'm now trying to predict based on the biological order, not just based on the personality traits or psychological perspective. So simply, similarly, if you go for the third trait, that is, this part is actually about the earth and water, and you are actually more colds and problems and depressions may come on you if you are from this biological order or from this part. So this is the thing. The other theory is from this Jung, and he has predicted how the thinking and feeling and the combination of sensation and intuition and how the mix of this could develop your personality. Not just one good personality out of five, or you are not scaling yourself, but you can lie in particular quadrant, and we will see this the more details in our live session for this regard. So let's continue with this, and further we will have some more theory, and we will try to now focus on this person to organization fit. So if you see, what is the person to organization fit? For example, if you are a software engineer, you want to become a software engineer, then rather you are more focused and introvert. So once I will check your personality trait as an HR manager before hiring you, then it will be a good blend of my organization culture and your personality. But at the same time, if for the same software house you are more communicative and you like to welcome the more people as a customer service, then I may ask you for the go for the system analysis. You will visit frequently different organization, you will talk to people, and you will ask, okay, what type of system do you need, how I can create that interface, what sort of problem you are facing. Then with that communication skills, you interpret all that analysis towards your programmers actually. Similarly, you can find this person to organization fit for your bank mascot. If you are introvert, you can you are really good for cashier or bank manager. So we will see this, how people have high on extroversion fit well with the aggressive and team oriented cultures. For example, department of marketing, within the same department you can see people high on agreeableness match much better with the sportive organization climate than a focused on aggressive. So you see, this is the way your big five personality which we have just studied, we are trying to relate it for your organization. So if you go for the people high on openness to the experience fit better in the organization that emphasizes innovation rather than standardization. If you see the quality assurance people over there, they have different personality traits. They go and they can read between the lines. They keep on improving the things with the documentation and all those processes and repeat them with the time. But sometime like teachers, they may be bored. They want to be more innovative and they want to write more papers and they want to try more subjects in this regard. Same is the situation for the entrepreneur. If you are an entrepreneur, you may be bored from daily routine of opening the bank accounts. You will like to have your own, rather you would like to have your own farmhouse, and you enjoy the life over there. It depends the way your job is and how it fits with your organization. So this is the more we will discuss more details in the lecture, inshallah, in the live session. So let's talk about the personality and the values over here. So personality and values, let's try to define it. Personality represents our pattern of thinking and feeling, while values represent what we believe to be the right. Okay, they are deeply the helpful principle to guide our choice and influence our emotions as well. In the next lecture we will talk about the emotions and mood as well. So before that, so for example, what is my value? For example, my value, what I value is, for example, to coming on time, the well organized, and being punctual and doing a job from 8 to 4. Therefore, doing the right things and giving proper time for the counseling. Similarly, your value could be to receive the customer with proper respect, irrespective of what is the problem going on at your home or with your boss or with the organization. This is you value most such type of values. So we will now take some example of the values. For example, achievement, the desire for the personal success, and similarly, you may take the example of the power. For example, similarly, you may go for the security, valuing the safety and stability. You would like to have more stability at workplace and not to switch the job all that after years and years and things like that. So so these are the different values, and we will discuss more details and their differences in our live session as well. and we will see how the impact conflict and nature and use of personality and values and how to compare those. And this is all for today. Let's have some implications for our theories. For example, we have some implications for the manager. For example, considering the screening job candidate, you should use this personality test. And although there are some problem with this Big Five and MBTI, but still you can use them. For example, your military job, still they are using those IQ and personality test over there. And for evaluation of jobs and work groups and your organization to determine the optimal personality fit, it is a daily routine as an HR manager. So when individuals becomes more aware of their values, it helps them to make choices with which they feel comfortable. So this is all about the managerial application, and thank you for week one, and see you in week two. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.